Good morning, student. I, Purnima, welcome you to the class. And today I am going to teach you the lesson, The Lost Child, written by Mulk Raj Anand. So, who is the writer of this lesson? He is a very famous writer, Mulk Raj Anand. Children, you know that there are very few students of English writers are there in English language. In India, generally, mostly you will find much more Hindi writers, but there are many very, very less writers are there who are writing in English. So, this story, Mulk Raj Anand, is written by, the story, The Lost Child, is written by Mulk Raj Anand. The child goes to the fair. So, children, let me tell you about the background of this story. The child goes to the fair. It was the festival of spring. All the people were going to it. Now, children, there are few points which we will be discussing in this chapter. So, first of all, the first point is the child goes to the fair. Okay, so here in this story, the child goes to the fair. It was the festival of spring. All the people were going to it. Some walked, some rode on horses, some in bullock cart. The little child ran with his parents. He was overjoyed when he remained behind. His father asked him to come. He remained behind to see the toys in the shop. So, since they were going to the village fair, so there were so many types of shops were there. And here, the first scenario of the fair is that the child is enjoying the fair. He is going towards the shop and he wants to have something. But let's see whether he gets it or not. So, he is overjoyed when he sees it. Okay. He remained behind to see the toys in the shops where his parents walked ahead. The little boy wanted the toy. Now, children, he was a little boy. He wanted to have the toys. But his parents could not buy it. So, they asked him to look at other things. Now, the parents straight away, they refused. They told that they are not going to buy that toys. And poor child, he was helpless. And what is the second point? Now, children, he is attracted towards the child. Is attracted towards other things. Okay, the child is attracted towards other things. Alright, so let us discuss now what are the things that a child gets attracted to. So, it was the season of mustard flower. Beautiful golden yellow mustard flowers were there all over. The field looked gold with it. It was looking as if the field was full of gold. The dragonflies were fluttering high over the mustard flower. The child tried to catch one of them. But he was called by his mother. He ran gladly toward his parents. So, children, he ran gladly towards his parents. He heard the dove crowing. So, children, at first he was attracted by the mustard flowers. And finally, children, he saw dove crowing. And he was attracted towards dove. He had picked up the petals in the grove then. He also ran around the banyan tree. But again, he was called by his parents. The child with parents reached the fair. Now, children, the third point is that the child with parents reached the fair. So, the first point is the child goes to the fair with his parent. He is very happy. He is enjoying each and everything. Then the child gets attracted towards some other things. Okay. Like dove, mustard, flowers, flower showering on him. He was holding in the palm and felt happy. Now, let's see what is the third point of the chapter. So, the third point of the chapter is that the child with parents reaches the fair. Third, the child with parents reaches the fair. Okay, now here, soon the child reached the fair. He heard a sweetmeat seller calling gulab jamun, rasogulla, barfi, jalebi. So first shop was of sweetmeat which was there in the fair. Okay, and he heard a sweetmeat seller. He was calling gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebis. The sweet shop was greatly decorated with different color sweets. Seeing the sweet, the child mouth watered. He said, "I want the barfi." Barfi was his favorite sweet, but his saying so was unheeded. Various scenes of the fair. Now, children, the fourth thing. Now, children, he want his favorite barfi, but he knew he will not get it. Okay. Now, various scenes of the fair. Now, children, the fourth point is various scenes of the fair. Now, what else the child saw in the fair? Now, here the child is going towards the fair and he sees his many things. So, what things he had seen? The child went ahead with his parents. He heard a flower seller saying a garland of gulmohar. The child went to the flower basket. He wanted a garland, but he knew his parents would refuse to buy him that. So he moved on. Then he saw a balloon seller. He saw different color rainbow color balloon which were of various color. He knew the parents will never buy it. So he walked further now. Now let's see what other thing he found. Okay. Well, now the times come when the child is lost in the fair. So here now the child is lost in the fair. Okay. The child knew his parents would not buy him a balloon, so he walked further. Now, children, then he came to the snake charmer. The child then saw a snake charmer. He was playing a flute to a snake. He went near the snake charmer, but he knew that his parents had asked him not to hear much music. So he went ahead. Then he saw a merry-go-round. Men, women, children, etc. were enjoying a ride on it. The child called, "I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother." But then the saddest thing was that he did not get the reply. The child turned at the back and he saw that the parents were not there. Now, children, he was very sad and he started crying, running in there. Okay. So, then the next point is there. The sixth point. The child is worried. And runs here and there. And runs here and there. So children, when he wanted to go to the roundabouts, okay, but then there was no reply. The child had been lost. He had been very worried. Okay, he started crying, rose within the child's deep throat. What did he cry? He cried, "Father and mother." Tears rolled down his eyes. He cried and cried and ran to and fro, but he could not see his parents. People laughed and talked. Then he ran to a shrine. There was a big crowd. The child lost. There was a big crowd there. The child went a bit ahead between the people's feet, but he was pushed back. A man heard his cry. He lifted him up to his arms. The man tries to locate the child's parents. Now, children, finally, a man saves him. and the man tries to find the child's parents. Okay, so here the man, he is trying to find the child parent. The man asks the child how to go there. He also asks the name of his parents, but the child only said, "I want my father, I want my mother, I want my parents." The man took the child to the merry-go-round. Children, now the child refuses the things. Children, the child which he wanted very much, okay, now he is avoiding it. He refuses that he will be sitting in the merry-go-round. He asked him if he wanted to ride on the horse, but the child said only that he wanted his mother. Then the man asked him if he would take a balloon, but the child sobbed and sobbed again. The child is taken to the flower seller and sweetmeat shop. The man then took the child to the flower seller. He asked him if he would like to put a garland around his head. The child turned his nose. He only said, "I want my mother, I want my father." Then the man asked him which sweet he would like. Again the child hurt his face. He said, "I want my father and I want my mother." So this is the story, children. Now let me tell you about the theme of this story. What is the theme of this story is? Now children, the theme of this story, which is written by Mulk Raj Anand, okay, he is a well-known writer. It goes deep into the reader's heart. It shows that parents are an indispensable part of a child. Although a child is childish in nature, he is more serious than an adult sometimes. He values his parents, the dearest of all in the world. Now, so children, it was a festival of spring, and the child walked with his parents in a festival of spring. He remained behind some time as he was drawn towards some attractive things being shown there. He saw a toy shop and wanted one, but his father looked at him with red eyes, so they moved on. He knew he would not get the toy. Then demanding behavior, then he came across a sweetmeat seller. The child's mouth began to water. He demanded barfi in a slow voice, but there was no answer. They walked on. Next, there stood a flower seller. The child desired for a garland of gulmohar, but he was again not given. Then he saw a balloon in various color, red, green, blue color. Knowing his parents would not accept his request, he quietly followed them. Lost child. Now children, then suddenly the child's eyes fell on a snake charm. He liked the charming tune, but his mother asked him to move faster. The child ran towards them, but his leg stopped him near a roundabout. He wanted to enjoy the ride, but when he called his parents, there was no reply. Perhaps they had gone very far. They were not seen or found anywhere. Time stopped for him, and his voice also stopped. His all desires ended. There was now only one desire: my mother, my father. He cried bitterly for them. Importance of parents. Now a man from the crowded fair tried to console him, but no effect. He took him to the roundabout, the snake charmer, the balloon seller, flower seller, sweet seller, and last of all to the toy seller. But again, nothing happened. He ordered him to take any of the item, but failed to keep him quiet. The only desire he wanted to fulfill was his parent. The boy spoke nothing. He only told in the last that, "I want my mother and I want my father." The story is written by Mulk Raj Anand, and it goes deep into the reader's heart. The story that parents are an indispensable part of a child. Although the child is childish in nature, he is more serious than adult sometimes. He values his parents, the dearest of all in the world. So children, this is all about the background of the story. I've told about the writer of the story, and now I will be doing the children, I'm going to read the lesson, the lost child, and we will be doing the explanation part. A child goes to a fair with his parents. He is happy and excited and wants a sweet and toys displayed there. So what is the meaning of displayed? Shown. I've already written the meaning of the first paragraph. So displayed here means shown. But his parents don't buy them. So his parents doesn't buy them for him. Why then does he refuse when someone else offered them to him? So it was the festival of spring. From the wintry shade of narrow lanes and alleys. Alleys are the narrow passes. What are alleys? Alleys are the narrow passes. Gaily means with joy. Brimming means full of. Displayed, I already tell you the meaning of displayed is shown. So, it was the festival of spring. So, what was the festival? It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alley. Now children, the wintry shades, that means children, the day was not bright. Wintry shade means the day was not bright as if it was there in the summer season. So from that dark shades of winter, narrow lanes could be seen on alley. Alley means narrow passage. Emerged a gaily clad in humanity. Emerged means comes out. So from that narrow lane and passages, what comes out? A gaily. Gaily means with joy. That means a lot of people were seen coming out and they were very happy. That humanity here, that means all human beings were very happy. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat being carried in bamboo and bullock cart. One little boy ran between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. And children, among these people, a small boy was there. And he was running between his father's leg and mother's leg as they were also going to see the fair. Come child, come, called his parents as he lagged behind. Lagged means remained behind. So you can note down the meaning of lagged. So lagged means remain behind. So, come child, come, called his parents as he lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shop that lined the way. Children, he was fascinated. What is the meaning of fascinated? Attracted. So children, there were a lot of toys and he was attracted by those toys. The toys were put in a nice manner with in a row. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call. And suddenly, his feet hurried towards his parents. His feet were obedient to the call of his parents. His eyes still lingering on the receding toys. Lingering means remaining behind, and receding means disappearing. Nice words. Lingering means remaining behind. Okay. Lingering means remaining behind, and receding means disappearing. Appearing. So now his eyes were still fixed on the toys, and but since he was running towards his parents, so all the toys were remaining disappearing from his eyes as he was running towards his parents. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him. And children, he came to that place where they had stopped and the parents were waiting for him. He could not suppose the desire of his heart, even though he well knew his old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. Now children, he suppressed, means to press the feeling. He could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. Stare means to gaze. So he knew that finally what his father will do, he will simply stare. He would do what? He would simply stare. He would simply gaze, stare him. The cold stare, that means that cold stare means refusal for toys from his parents. He knew that nobody is going to buy it. So he moved ahead. I want that toy, he pleaded. But then finally, children, he pleaded, he requested, and he told his parent. Pleaded means requested. Okay. He pleaded. Pleaded means requested. He pleaded his parents, he requested his parents. Buy the toy. His father looked at him red eyes. Red eye means he was a bit angry. Okay, what is the meaning of red eye? Red eye means children, his father was a bit angry. So, in familiar tyrant way, tyrant means in a very cruel manner. Children, when he asked, when he was pleading for the toys, his father just stared at him in a very cruel manner, red-eyed, that means in a very angry and cruel manner. The child was scared, and his mother melted, but his mother, she was feeling guilty conscious because they were poor, their financial condition was not good. She knew that it is their fault that they are not able to afford whatever the child wanted. So she melted by the free spirit of the day, was tender, and giving him her finger to hold, said, "Look, child, what is before you?" So she wanted, she was helpless because they were not having money. That's why they were behaving like that. So she told the boy that, "Look, what is before you?" It was flowering mustard field, pale like melting gold at its sweat across miles and miles of even land. So she told that, "You can see what is there." It was flowering mustard field, pale like melting gold at its sweat across miles and miles of even land. Then she told, "Just look, a beautiful gold color flowers are there, as if the gold is melting." Okay, and it was melted gold is can be seen miles and miles of even land. A group of dragonflies was bustling about on their gaudy purple wings. Bustling means moving, basically with energy. So what dragonfly were doing, they were bustling with energy. Gaudy is showy, and children, they were tinge of purple shades were there on their wing. So they were bustling, they were moving their wings, intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. And they were, children, interrupting the flight of a black bee or butterfly in search of the sweetness from the flowers. Child follow them in the air with his gaze till one of them would still its wing and rest, and he would try to catch it, but it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air when he had almost caught it in his hand. Then his mother gave a cautionary call, "Come, child, come to onto the footfall." So children, he was gazing those dragonfly. Then the mother called the child. She told, "Come, child, come." Okay, she gave him a cautionary. Cautionary is alerting. What is the meaning of cautionary? Cautionary mere means she gave him an alerting call. "Come, child, come to the footpath." He ran towards his parents gaily. Gaily is merrily. Merrily or with joy. So that child, he was a very innocent child. He ran gaily towards where his mother wants him to move, and walked abreast. What is the meaning of abreast? Side by side, side by side. It means abreast of them for a while. Being, however, soon left behind, the child was soon left behind, attracted by the little insect and worms. He was attracted by the little insects and worms, along with the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. So, children, along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding place to enjoy the sunshine. So, children, he was enjoying the coming of the worm. Okay. And who were coming, teeming out, that means lot of worms, they were coming from out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. Come, child, come. His parents called from the shades of grove where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. He ran toward them. Come, child, come. His parents called from the shade of a grove where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. He ran towards them. So, come, child, come. His parents called him. They were resting. They called from the shade of a grove where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. So the parents were a bit tired, so they were taking rest on the edge of a well. They seated themselves. He ran towards them. The child ran towards them. A shower of young flower fell upon the child as he entered the grove. Grove means orchard of fruit. So children, when the child ran there, what happened? When he entered the grove, children, a shower of young flower fell upon the child as he entered the grove, and forgetting his parents, he began to gather the raining petals in his hands. But lo, he heard the cooing of doves and ran towards his parents, shouting, the dove, the raining petals drop from his forgotten hand. So children, so he was, flowers were showering on his hand. He was very happy. He was putting his hand and collecting the petals of the flowers which were dropping down from the tree. But he heard the cooing of dove. Doves are the pigeons, white pigeons. So he heard the cooing of the dove, and then he ran towards his parent shouting, the dove, the raining petal drop from his forgotten hand. Come, child, come. They called to the child, who had now gone running in wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathering him up, they took the narrow winding footpath which led to the fair through the mustard field. Come, child, come. They called to the child, who had now gone running in wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathering him up, they took the narrow winding footpath. Winding means that circular path. Okay. So from there, they have come to the circular footpath which led to the fair through the mustard field, and children, finally there was a mustard field. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirlpool of the fair. So children, some hard word meaning, as they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs. Okay. So, so here you can see, children, write the meaning of throngs. Crowd. So children, he had seen the throngs, he had seen the crowd converging to the whirlpool of the fair. Converging means children, moving around. Okay. and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. Repelled, children, a group of people, crowded. Okay, so repelled means driven back. Repelled means driven back. So children, he was driven back when he saw so many people were there gathering at a one place. They all want to go to the fair. So he was a bit confused. Okay, he was a bit surprised, and he was fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. He was a bit confused because he hadn't seen crowd, so much crowd, children. He hadn't seen that crowd. So with this, this part of the video, I end and wait for the next part of the lesson, which I will be telling you in my other video. Thank you.